Welcome to this week's video. For this week, I am doing another edition of Speed Dating My TBR. This is number 9, I think. And what happens is I grab some books from that massive bookcase. Four books. And I read the first chapter, prologue, or first 10 pages, whichever comes first, and decide if it's going to go back on my TBR or if I will be sending it to a better home. So, got my four books here, and yeah, let's just get started straight into it. We are starting with Sandra Brown's White Hot. Now, I am not that much of a mystery person, if you are new here, unless it has to do with, like, family secrets or, you know, children sort of, like, one of them was kidnapped, and then, like, they come back, but is it, like, really them, or, that sort of kind of stuff. I'm not much into, like, the whodunit type of mysteries. I like more sort of the other kind. So, and Sandra Brown, I love her earlier, like, romance, books, not so much, but she's more of like a thriller slash mystery person sort of now. But I picked up this one because, and I will read the back blurb for you. When her younger brother Danny commits suicide, Sayer Lynch, and she always has these like total like rich white person names, like Sayer. S-A-Y-R-E, breaks her vow never to return to her Louisiana hometown and gets drawn back into her tyrannical father's web. He and her older brother, who control the town's sole industry, an iron foundry, are as corrupt as ever. Worse, they have hired a shrewd and disarming new lawyer, Beck Merchant, a man with his own agenda. When the police determine that Danny's suicide was actually a homicide, Sayer must battle her family and her passionate feelings for Beck as she confronts a powder keg of old hatreds, past crimes, and a surprising plan of revenge. Let's see. This was published in 2004, and I always like to read the first line. Some said that if he was going to kill himself, he couldn't have picked a better day for it. It's weird because I wasn't sure if I liked it, and then I changed my mind for the same reason that I wasn't sure that I liked it. Because it starts off more of sort of like a description of the scene of like the setting, and you get a of the description of sort of like the swamp and like the animals and the description of like the I can't words, oh my God. Of like the hawk and like the mouse and the and it's weird because I sort of see it as it sort of played out. And like that scene, that setting, it's punctuated by a gunshot at the end. And then like you for like a second you're kind of like in the hawk's point of view where you're like it's just sort of like bouncing around from like thing to thing and then like you hear a gunshot and then the hawk kind of takes off. And I was sort of like not at like the very beginning, and I'm talking about like just this is just like maybe 2 or 3 pages in because it starts with the prologue. And we're in like the setting and stuff and it's talking about the setting and I was like, I don't know if I'm liking this. But then sort of as it went on, I could almost sort of see it as like the beginning of a movie where like you're just getting this really sort of thick, beautiful, sort of swampy landscape and like ambiance, and then you get the ending of like a the sound of a gunshot, and then just the bird sort of flying away. And then I was like, oh, picturing it in my head as like a kind of a movie, I really liked that. So, yeah, it was weird because it's only like 2 pages, but it totally like sucked me in. For the same reason that I wasn't sure if I liked it. But yeah, no, it worked. That prologue worked. So, White Hot is going back. Oh, let me just mark so that I know that I read this one. That I previewed this one. Because y'all, I have like tons of books still to preview and stuff, so and then I mark off where I read so that I know that so that I don't pick that one again for like another video. Next we have Dean Koontz's Velocity. Now, I like Dean Koontz. And I'm sort of making my way through kind of his backlist because ever since I read Karen Slaughter's Pieces of Her, which check out the video of my best books of 2023, 20 best and worst, and you'll see that that was among my best books of 2023. Ever since her book, I've sort of been wanting to give mysteries kind of another look. And I remember always sort of liking Dean Koontz, and my sister's a huge fan of his, so I'm sort of wanting to read more of his books. And so I picked up this one, and the insert cover is the note that is left to this man on this man's car. So, let's read the back blurb. If you don't take this note to the police, I will kill a lovely blonde schoolteacher. If you do, I will instead kill an elderly woman active in charity work. You have 6 hours to decide. The choice is yours. The typewritten note under his windshield seems like just a sick joke. But in less than 24 hours, Billy Wiles, an ordinary hardworking guy, is about to see his life take on the speed of a nightmare. Because a young blonde school teacher is murdered, and now Billy has another note, and another deadline. This time he knows it's no joke. He's racing a killer faster than evil itself, and Billy must accept his terrifying challenge. The choice is yours. So, yeah. Let's... Published in 2005. First line reads, with draft beer and a smile, Ned Purcell raised a toast to his deceased neighbor, Henry Friddle, whose death greatly pleased him. I know that, like, neighbors have issues sometimes, but... I'm sorry, I have to read the next line. Okay. With a draft beer and a smile, Ned Purcell raised a toast to his deceased neighbor, Henry Friddle, whose death greatly pleased him. Henry had been killed by a garden gnome. Oh my god, okay. Oh lord. I was not expecting to be laughing at a Dean Koontz book, but here we are. Here, like, peeing on windows, peeing in windows, putting your neighbor's face on a gnome. Expect to be laughing in the beginning of a Dean Koontz book, but that opening was hilarious. I will say, I wonder if the tourist guy is the killer, because they're at a bar, and Billy's a bartender, the main character, and the guy who was toasting his neighbor's death, the guy Ned, was telling this tourist guy the story of why he's happy his neighbor is dead. And again, like I said, there's these sort of like petty kind of neighbor war stuff. A very sort of, just a bad, bad relationship. So, I don't, yeah. I don't know. Just my first instinct is that this random tourist guy, he's my first suspect. He's my first guess. And again, I'm not a big sort of like whodunit person, but with a premise like this, where like the main character gets a letter, and if he does this, then this person will die. If he doesn't do this, then another person will die, and he's trying to like stop these murders from happening. And he's just like an ordinary dude. That I really like that premise. So, yeah, this one's going back too. So that's two. We're two for two. Next we have Joanna Shupe's The Lady Gets Lucky, the Fifth Avenue Rebels series. And it's got a blurb from Sarah McLean, who sadly, Sarah McLean's books have not worked for me. Yeah, I just. But let's see if Joanna Shupe does. So let's read the back blurb. Shy heiress Alice Lusk is tired of being overlooked by every bachelor. Something has to change, else she'll be forced to marry a man whose only desire is her fortune. She needs to become a siren, a woman who causes a man's blood to run hot, and she's just met the perfect rogue to help her. Christopher Kit Ward has plans, serious plans that do not involve an innocent spinster. But when Alice comes to him with a trade that's too good to refuse, Kit finds himself giving carnal lessons to the most beguiling wallflower he's ever met, and what's more, he's enjoying himself. Their bedroom instruction grows passionate, and Alice is a much better pupil than Kit had ever anticipated. When the society gentlemen start to take notice, Kit has to try to win Alice in other ways. But is he too late to win her heart? Of course not. And this was published in 2021. All right, smack in the middle of COVID. And first line reads, "You are the most adorably charming man," the older woman said as she patted Kit's arm. So far, I just want to read you this bit. "Are you embarrassed of being called clever?" When she sighed and looked down at her hands, he had his answer. "Being smart is nothing to be ashamed of." "Of course you'd say that," she said. "You're a man. It's not the same for women. We shouldn't aspire for intelligence." "That's absurd. Who told you such nonsense?" "My mother. No spirits and an attitude of women worthy of a caveman. I believe I don't care for your mother." I like him.
Thank you.
like it so far. So Alice's plan, because she clearly has a trash mother who tells her that most men, like, men won't mind your plain face when they see the size of your dowry. She has a large dowry, and according to her mother, that's her only redeeming quality. So she, Alice, doesn't want some old man or a fortune hunter who just wants her for her dowry. She wants a handsome husband that she could fall in love with. So she heard that Kit is good with women and could turn the most innocent woman into a vixen. So she thinks that if he teaches her how to seduce a man, it could give her confidence and make her more fun and engaging and attractive to men. The right kind of men, the kind of men that she actually would want to marry. So she sneaks into his bedroom and asks him to teach her how to seduce a man, as you do. So I like it so far, and I really like how he is with her. How he sort of calls the way that her mother, even in just this short little interaction, the way that her mother is treating her stupid. And I'm very much looking forward to him standing up for her against her mother and sort of teaching her that the way that her mother talks to her and thinks of her is not right. So I'm very much looking forward to this. I think that thus far, this is giving me sexy vibes, but that it's going to give me all the feels too. So this one's going back onto the shelf as well. Oh, yeah. So I want to say that this is successful, but it's not really so far, because the aim is to get that monstrosity down, like lower, less on there, not the same amount. But we're getting good books so far. We'll see with the last one, Sultana, written by Prince Michael of Greece. I remember when I first got this book, I thought the hero of the book was that it was like the subtitle of the book. Like, it's Sultana, and that she falls in love with this Prince Michael of Greece. No, he's the author. So, it was written in 1983. 1983, wow. Oh, we got a map. Oh, that is some small ass print. Holy crap. Look how tiny that is. Yeesh. Okay. First line reads, I far prefer this new residence of mine to the Seraglio, where I spent so many years. Oh, wait, I forgot to read the back blurb. A precious jewel amid the shimmering enchantments of the royal harem. She was the heart of golden splendored empire, commanding destiny for the adoring young sultan who could never love her openly, and the son who must live to one day take the throne. Amy was just a girl when, driven from France by the revolution, she was captured by pirates and sent to the sultan's seraglio. Seraglio? Seraglio? Words. Fearing a shame worse than death, she found instead undying love, a glorious love invincible against jealous intrigues, treachery, and the clash of armies. Say the print is very small, so my eyes will definitely get tired reading this, but I have my reading glasses, so but I likely will be taking this to work probably. So I don't have my reading glasses when I go to work because I just read sort of in on my commute and during my breaks and stuff, but so little Amy is being dragged along to see the village psychic by her friend Josephine, who is told that Josephine is told by this psychic that she will marry, I think, twice, and that the second man will be small in stature but will command a great empire. And I don't think I'm out of, I don't think I'm wrong in assuming that we are talking about Napoleon. And it's that Josephine, his wife, that is friends with this girl, Amy. And, the psychic tells Amy that She'll be on a ship that will be attacked by pirates, and she will be kidnapped and sent to this man, this unhappy ruler, but that they will fall in love, and that she will be stuck there at this man's kingdom. And that I want to like make sure that you will earn the love of an unhappy ruler. You will command a great empire. You will have a son. How strange. That son will be neither your son nor that ruler's. So she'll have a son, but it won't be her biological son? And that son will be like the next ruler, I guess, after the guy who Amy, the unhappy ruler dude. So yeah, like very sort of small. Very small print, but I like it so far. I definitely sort of want to know more. The setup for this, and I wonder if the inspiration for it was based on this Turkish Sultana, who was sort of brought there by, like she wasn't a Turkish woman, I don't believe. She was kidnapped and brought there, and she actually ended up falling in love with her husband, the Sultan, and being like, well, I think one of his favorite concubines or what have you, and then he ended up marrying her. And it was the basis of this Turkish drama that I enjoyed the first season or two of Kosem, Kosem. If you Google that, and sort of that plot, it sort of reads like this a little bit. A little bit, like there was no like Josephine Bonaparte or anything like that, but it sort of gives me like that kind of vibe. But yeah, so I like it. I like it enough to sort of keep reading. It's gonna be hard with this very small print. But whoosh, how many pages is it? 438 pages. But the print is so small that I think if this were regular print, this would run to like probably like 800 pages. Easy. So, yeah, they're all going back on the shelf. Successful yet not. Because the mission of these videos is to get that mountain down, but successful in the sense of like we still have like really sort of good books to look forward to. So we made no headway, but there we are. So I hope you enjoyed that. Let me know sort of which books you're looking forward to me reading the most, and yeah, make sure that you're subscribed to get more of these videos as we make my way through that mountain and the mountain that you don't see over there and the little mountains that are sort of around here. Yeah, so I guess that's gonna be it for this week's video. Follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/authorejamie. Like my Facebook page at facebook.com/authorejamie, and I will talk to you guys next time. Bye!